So Russ picked up the playmaking slack without LeBron. Westbrook was the ball handler on 48 pick plays, including 27 with Anthony Davis as a screener. That's as many pick plays as the duo ran in the first three games combined. And Westbrook also has increased his number of drives in every game this season. So for more on the Lakers, we bring in the man, the myth, the legend, Stephen A. Smith, making his NBA Today debut. Hey, Stephen A. It was the Russell Westbrook show in San Antonio last night. Stephen A., what did you see from Russ in this breakout game for the Lakers?
Nothing really. I mean, I think that a lot of people are making a big deal out of it. I need to say nothing. And the reason why is because what hasn't Russell Westbrook done before in terms of this kind of play? He scored 33 points. Is that a surprise? He had about 10 rebounds. Is that a surprise? He had about 8 assists. Is that a surprise? The man is a walking triple-double. We know what he can do. The suspense involving Russell Westbrook isn't in his points, rebound, or assist production as an individual star in this league. It's whether or not he can register those kind of results with both Anthony Davis and LeBron James on the floor with him. The fact that LeBron James was out is why I say what I say about Russell Westbrook. I'm not talking about him. We know he's great, future Hall of Famer. He's phenomenal. What we're saying is the suspense involving Russell Westbrook in a Lakers uniform is what can he do with both of them on the floor? Because if the Lakers are going anywhere, both of them are going to have to be on the floor with Russell Westbrook, and what he's able to do in terms of ingratiating himself with them as teammates in terms of chemistry, that's going to decide the fate of the Los Angeles Lakers.
Interesting. So we're not going to see that tonight because we know that LeBron James has already been ruled out, but we've seen a few different versions of the Lakers this season, and it's early. But what do you think is the best version of Los Angeles, Stephen A.?
Well, to me, as far as I'm concerned, it still includes Russell Westbrook. All this noise about, hey, you know, let him come off the bench. He's Russell Westbrook. He starts and finishes every game throughout his career. And then all of a sudden, his 12th year in the league with him being one of the top 75 players in NBA history, a surefire first ballot future Hall of Famer, a walking triple-double. All of a sudden, we're going to talk to him about coming off the bench. It's not going to happen. We all know that's not going to happen. So it's really about looking at him, looking at Anthony Davis, looking at LeBron James. And then I say to myself, excuse me, Malik Monk, let his confidence elevate to some degree, and that could definitely be a plus. And Carmelo Anthony, I think Carmelo Anthony is going to be a key component with the Los Angeles Lakers this year because he's a perimeter threat. Obviously, he didn't show that last night. He showed that the game before, though, when he dropped 28. In the end, what it comes down to is that you're going to have to leave Melo open when you're talking about Anthony Davis, LeBron James, and Russell Westbrook on the floor together. And I think that that could be an ingredient for success with the Los Angeles Lakers with those guys in the lineup together.
Well, we've seen the Staples Center crowd just go crazy for Carmelo Anthony, so we know that they love him. But Stephen A., put on your Dr. Stephen A. hat for a second, if you could.
Sure.
How cautious would you be with LeBron James and Anthony Davis here?
As cautious, well, in the case of Anthony Davis, definitely cautious. I mean, bringing a surgeon, a podiatrist, a masseuse, I mean, everything. Give him everything he needs because the one impediment to his success has been his durability. In the case of LeBron James, trust him. Listen to him. This is a guy that takes phenomenal care of his body. He's constantly monitoring himself in terms of making sure that he's in peak condition. And he's proven over the years, not only that he's durable, but that he's trustworthy. He knows his body better than anybody else. So you listen to him and let him guide you as to when he deems himself ready and when he doesn't. But we all know that this Lakers team is assembled for playoff action. Carmelo's 37, LeBron's 36, Russell Westbrook is 32, going on 33. Anthony Davis has been in the league for a while. We know Rondo's been in the league for a while. This is a team that's built for the postseason, not the regular season. So it's not important for them to be a top two or three seed. They could be a fourth or fifth seed. It does not matter. As long as they're healthy, they're a legitimate threat, and we all know that.
It's a marathon, not a sprint, right, Stephen A.? But I appreciate you putting your doctor's hat on for a little bit. Thank you for coming on. But will you stick around for me, and do you want to talk a little Knicks in a little bit?
Hey, listen, it's you and the ladies, Janae, and I mean, come on now. All y'all, of course, Ramona, I mean, I'm here for y'all. I'm here for y'all.
Oh, well, then can I get a little bit of a bing bong? Have you seen that going around?
Bing bong?
Yeah,
No. Here's what I'll give you. We here.
Oh.
I'm in New York. We here.
Well, then
I'll give you that.
We have to come back for that, Stephen A.
Yes.
I appreciate you.
Yes.
So we have more to talk about with the Lakers, though. We have spent some time talking about LeBron, Russ, AD, and even Carmelo, but Janae, you were focused on somebody else. Who was that?
It's Malik Monk. And, you know, I was just thinking about this Lakers game, and I kept thinking of create your own luck. But by definition, luck is where preparation meets opportunity. And Malik Monk is a perfect example of this. We knew AD is capable of having MVP caliber games. We knew Russ was capable of having MVP caliber games. But you create your own luck, especially in a role like Malik Monk did last night with his shooting ability. Y'all, I love it. Every LeBron James championship team has a shooter role player that comes and performs at a high level. And this three was it. That's what basically, you know, they were down two. They got the 2-point lead, you know, after he knocked down this three. I love that Rondo was able to, you know his role. He was the only non-shooter on the floor during that time period. Set a nice little screen, freed him up. It takes a lot of confidence and a little bit of luck to be able to feel good enough to, you know, hit that dagger shot. Malik Monk, his start to the year, he was plus 31 in 39 minutes, plus minus, plus 31 in 39 minutes. He's created his own luck pretty much for the Lakers, and that helps him, especially with LeBron James out.
And you're going to need to get those others going, as you mentioned, create that space on the floor. And Malik Monk has certainly stepped into team in the last 25 single seasons to win multiple games versus a single opponent after trailing by at least 19 in both games. How's that for specifics? SGA went off in both of those contests, leading OKC to its only two wins of the season in these comeback victories. So there's a lot to unpack here with the Lakers. Tim, I see you with an iPad in your hand. That means it's dangerous and you got something to show.
Yeah, we gotta make this thing sing a little bit.
All right, let's go take a look.
So look, this isn't gonna be all about Russ, but the bottom line is, Richard, some of the decision-making late in the game, it cost them an opportunity. And I'm going to show you really what Russell Westbrook was looking at, maybe what he should have been looking at. So let's start here. It's very important to notice, so people are aware, right? So you got a 2-point game of 27.8. That's a ton of time.
Lots of time.
You're not in a hurry. You don't have to rush, but it's about processing the defense. So here's the first thing to look at. As this ball comes off the floor, let's get it going. He's looking now. Let's stop it. Now, first off, take a look at Carmelo Anthony, right? Hands in the air, he's been hot. So right, and Russ is looking in that direction. So he's processing what's on the weak side of the floor. You've also got a shooter here, Avery Bradley, running to the corner. But here's the key. In order to get one of those guys a shot, you have got to engage the top defender. This ball has to be taken right here back to the middle. And now you've got to make one of these two weak side defenders react to you. And when they do, you now have an easy decision on the weak side. So as he gets right here, there is still time for Russ to take this ball to the middle of the floor. And if you can just get one of these guys to commit.
Hands are still open by Carmelo.
That's it. He's still waving. If the backline guy comes, it's an easy kick to the corner. If that doesn't happen, you want to drive middle if you're Russ? Let's get the top defender then to come pinch. If that's the case, again, easy decision on the kickout. The problem is Russ takes it too deep, too far, too many dribbles. And now he ends up in this situation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 defenders in the paint. He doesn't put the ball in his left hand. You don't even get a shot attempt. So, Rich, it's just bad execution and a really unfortunate turnover right there. Now, this one, Russ is now thinking, man, I turn the ball over. I got to make up for it. He's in a good spot here. You got a denial. They're in good position right here. Guy breaking into the backcourt. You got a denial there. Now, here's something that has nothing to do with Westbrook that they mess up. On this screen right here, and SGA comes in this direction, that's an easy switch. Carmelo Anthony has to switch to deny this. But watch what happens. As he comes off, both defenders stay with the screener.
SGA is open right there. He had a layup dunk they could have.
He could have. But he's thinking, let's play the free throw game. Mm-hmm. So what does he do? He breaks out here and they get it in. But now watch what happens. You're still in good shape if you're the Lakers. So SGA is going to try to dribble some clock. But as he brings it over, I mean, there's a lot of options here. You can get a trap here if you want to. He brings it over. You can get a trap here if you want to and try to make them pass the ball a couple times. The one thing you can't do, if you're Russell Westbrook, who is here, and this is your man, you cannot now get in a situation where you are chasing the basketball and you give a guy a free run to the rim and give up an easy dunk in a 2-point game with 15 seconds left. Cannot happen. And that's Russell just trying to make up for the turnover. And now this last one, I don't have a huge problem with it other than this. Richard, can you explain to me why is Russell Westbrook catching the ball at the foul line with all this space with 7 seconds left? There's no reason for him to catch the ball in this area of the floor with 7 seconds. He could have caught the ball literally up here, and it gives you more options now of what you can do. Now, the rest of this, I think, is Frank Vogel. This is just a really poorly designed play. Like, here's the screen. They're trying to get Melo coming up, but look what Russ is looking at. I mean, he's looking in that direction. He sees it. The problem is, Rich, Here's what he sees. Four defenders and three offensive players. It's just too crowded to try to throw the ball cross court. It's just a really poorly designed play. So, of course, what Russ is going to do, he's going to say, you know what, I'm going to go ahead and launch this up because I know I can get this shot off. Very good contest by Dort. You don't get a quality possession. Hey, look, a lot of that looks like you're beating up Russell Westbrook. Sure. He and I have talked about this off the air. We love his competitive spirit, but sometimes the decision-making hurts you. And this is where LeBron James is on the floor. It's a little bit different. The ball's in his hands.
Absolutely. Well,
and then really quickly, the Lakers need Russell Westbrook. Look, I know there was conversation of this. The reason why you needed him is, like, Anthony Davis in this game was a minus 14. Mm. He put up big numbers, but they need someone to control the pace, especially when LeBron James is out. They just need him to play better. And these are little things that are controllable. He's got to get into a rhythm, but they're in a good spot, but they definitely need him to play a lot better.
Guys, I do want to bring in Zach here because we have spent so much time talking about the Lakers. But Zach, I got to get your thoughts. Give a little bit of shine to SGA.
Yeah, it's all Lakers, little Lakers. It can't all be Lakers.
Oh, with the little Lakers.
28 points on 17 shots, pulling up from the logo. Guys, he had on a pick and roll in the fourth quarter, a crossover into splitting defenders into a Euro step lefty finish where I screamed so loud I think I woke my wife up. It was so beautiful. The guy is averaging 24 points a game on 46% shooting, 39% from three. He's playing good defense. You saw the spirit, the fist pumping, the screaming last night. We haven't seen a lot of that out of him. He is growing in to an all-star level player, a centerpiece player for the Thunder. That's something that they can really pin to their hat going forward. Josh Giddey is for real. He's good. But SGA, all the attention's been on Ja Morant, and deservedly so, but this guy is a stud.
Yeah, the one thing that I would add is that SGA and this Oklahoma City team would be amazing if they played the Lakers every game.